But baby, it's cold outside. But baby, it's cold outside. Been hoping that you'd drop in. I'll hold your hands, they're just like ice.
Hello all, welcome back to Shaving with Peg Leg. How you doing tonight? It is Christmas Eve. Appreciate you all being here, and Merry Christmas to you and yours. Okay, face shave today. 1952, Gillette Black Tip. Supposed to be a mild shaver, so I have a first use, brand new, out of the package. Kai blade, never used a Kai blade before, but they're supposed to be a little wider, and you can see there's a lot of blade showing out from each side of those doors. It's supposed to be sharp too, so comparable to a feather. We will see. This is supposed to be a mild shaver. Put it in some warm water and see how it goes. I am using my cup warmer to warm up my lather. See how it's going. And it is not. It's been on for at least 10 minutes. Well, it could be 100. It's not 160 degrees. It didn't get that hot. There's just no way. I can put my hand on it for 3 seconds before I really start feeling the heat. So that's not 160 degrees. And for soap, but we're going to see if it works. I'm using Wet the Face Silent Night again, all the way through. I said through December, but I might just take it through Christmas. I'm not sure. I might take it all the way through December. Either way, still a great soap. Scents of honey, dried fruits, vanilla, sweet musk, sheer musk, and I forgot something. But the notes, scent notes are on the label. Floral jasmine. I got everything. I always forget one. Just the way the mind works sometimes. Excuse me. Excuse me again. Right now I'm just kind of waiting because I just put my made up, my whipped up lather on the warmer to see if it's working. So I'm kind of stalling for time. But we shall find out. Some water on the face. $10 eBay brush. It was when I bought it last year, about a year ago, I should say. It's like 23 millimeter knot. It's Badger. And the leather's not warm yet. But I really like the brush. It works really, really well. And I'm using it with, I like to use it with the stainless steel brush, or bowl, excuse me, because they go together. The only thing about this handle, it looks really good, is fingers are wet or you got soap on them. Make sure you circle grip it, because if you don't, right up the fingers and across the room it'll go. And a fun time you shall have chasing it. Okay, first use of this razor, 1952, Gillette Black Tip. And this is an X for 52 and 3 for third quarter, because in the third quarter, third quarter for the Black Tip and 52 was the first time they used a steel base plate and a steel handle. And I know the base plate was steel because, can you see it? That little bit of brown? That's the rust spot I scrubbed out of it, and I can't get the rest of it out. That's kind of in there. I probably can, but I think I'd have to use a brass brush to get it. And so far I've only used nylon, but since it's steel, I could use a brass brush and not scratch it and get that rust spot out. And I might do that one day. But right now, I've been busy playing with my more vintage razors, trying to get a blade worked out for it. Except my daughter came in Thursday night with her two daughters, my grandchildren, my granddaughters. And I had to clean the house clean. Very clean. All nice, pretty, like you would have your house for company. They were here 3 hours and it looked like a freaking tornado went through the place. And today, this morning, my youngest, the four-year-old, who is, I'll just say it, she's the spawn of Satan. Her favorite word is no. Her butt is made out of leather or concrete, or not sure which, because it doesn't affect her to be spanked. And she's just out there. She's really out there. She got a hold of, my daughter's been using my mom's bathroom because my mom's in rehab. That's fine, that's no problem. She got in there when my daughter was in the shower. Both girls had had their showers, had their hair done, and had their clothes on, ready to go. My daughter just had to take a shower, do her shit, get her clothes on, and out the door they were going to go. Well, the four-year-old, the youngest, got in under the cabinet in my mom's room. And my mom keeps a container. You've probably seen them. It's Arm & Hammer. And it's got the pop top on it. You shake the powder out on your carpeting. It kind of absorbs some of the odor. And then you vacuum. And it makes your carpet smell more fresh. So, anyways, she got a hold of that. And she popped the top on it. And I just bought that container for my mom. Less than 2 months ago, but more than a month ago, somewhere in that range, let's say six weeks ago. So it's only been used a couple times. She's going around my mom's room with the box, with the lid popped, with almost a full flip box. The box is about that tall. There's about that much in the bottom of it now. It was all over the nightstand, the dresser, the sink counter, the floors, the carpet, her hair looked like she had the worst case of dandruff you've ever seen or had been out in the snow. Her clothes and shoulders, she was white. And she thought it was the most grandest of time, laughing her butt off. Because I heard her laughing and I was like, okay, what is she into now? I had been out in the kitchen. And I went in there to see what she was laughing about, because anytime that child's laughing, she's doing something mischievous. So I go in there and I'm like, oh, flipping wonderful. Took the box away from her, gave her a whop on the butt, not that hard, not that soft, but just enough to say no. And she smirked at me like, I did it anyways, it's too late. I took the box and I put it in a place where she couldn't reach it anymore with what was left in it. And I kind of cleaned her up, her face up a little bit to get stuff out of her face. And her mom got out of the shower finally and she got done. And she looked in, because the shower and the toilet are in a separate room, and she had that door closed from the sink and like the makeup area with a big wall mirror. Well, I was back out in the kitchen, just doing a little prep for tomorrow. And I heard a, what the is all of this? I was like, oh, you finally saw it. She's like, how could I not see it? It's everywhere. I said, yep. She goes, let me guess. Trinity. I said, yep. She said, what is it? And I explained to her what it is, and she just shook her head. I said, oh, you haven't even seen her yet. She goes, oh, no. That girl's ready to go out the door before I went in the shower. I said, yeah, she was. So she yells for Trinity, and Trinity goes in. I had her sitting on the couch. I cleaned her up as best I could, and she goes in there, and she's looking at her hair going. I said, oh, no, she was worse. She was a lot worse. I cleaned her up. So, now, she needed another shower to get the carpet cleaner out of her head. My daughter's like, she does this kind of stuff all the time. I said, and you do this all the time. I said, you get her ready, then you go get ready, and by the time you come back, you got to get her ready all over again. I said, why don't you save her till the other one's ready to go out the door, you're ready to go out the door, and do her last. Start to finish, do her last. She says, I'm going to have to. She says, this is ridiculous. I said, I asked my daughter, I said, do you know who she takes after? She says, if you say me, I'm going to hit you right in the head. And she had her shoe in her hand. She's like, I'm going to hit you right in the head if you say me. I was like, okay, I won't say it. But you were the bane of your mother's existence. You always were good for me, but for your mother, you were Satan's spawn. She's like, I know, you keep telling me. So does she. I'm like, well, you're just getting back what we went through. She's like, but it's not right for one little child to be so evil. I told my daughter, I said, she's not evil. She's just mischievous. But she's also the same one. She has a toy. And the toy has glitter in it, little sparkles all through the toy. And she has discovered, and she didn't discover it until she got here, of course, that if she smacks it on something, the little sparkle glittery things fly everywhere. You cannot walk anywhere in this house and not see glitter sparkles everywhere. My floor in here, I just washed the little rugs I have in here. They now twinkle like stars. I'm fine. They just twinkle. They're fine. My living room floor, if it was black, it'd be like looking at the night sky. This child is, she's like her mother was at that age. So any of you out there that don't have kids yet, be thankful because they could turn out like that. Seriously. That's a good blade, guys. It's working. That Kai blade is working really, really well in this mild razor. Really well. It's amping the aggression up just to the point where you would want it. It's not overly aggressive. Still got my spots to do. But I always, no matter what razor I use, I always have my spots. And of course, now the lather's starting to get warm. maybe I need to start it a little sooner. But it's not getting as hot as they said it would, at least from the time I've had. Because they said it only takes about 10 minutes to warm up, and it's been on for more than that. By the time you see this video, I hope and pray that you all have your Christmas gifts. And for you married gentlemen, when you asked your wife what she wanted for Christmas and she said nothing, I hope you went the extra mile and got her something really, really nice, because that's what she said. When she said nothing, she said, I want you to pick me something really, really nice. And if you got her nothing, I pray that you have a very comfortable couch, because you're going to be spending a few nights on it. Maybe I'll do that with my shaving videos. I'll teach speaking woman code. Because when they say nothing, what they're saying is, I know what I want, but I want to see what you will get me. And it's not nothing. Trust me, it's not nothing. Guys, if you have a problem with your woman, your wife, your girlfriend, whatever, and you ask her, where do you want to go to eat? And she goes, oh, I don't care. Pick a place. And you pick a place. She goes, I don't want to go there. And you pick another place. No, I don't want to go there. And you pick another place. I don't want to go there. Well, where do you want to eat? Oh, I don't care. Just anywhere. And you pick a place. I don't want to go there. That happens a lot. Ask her, guess where I've decided to take you for dinner tonight? And whatever her answer is, that's where you take her. And you go, you're right, I was going to take you there. Because that's where she really wants to go. Don't ask her, where do you want to go to eat? Ask her to guess where you're going to take her. Hey, babe, guess where I want to take you for dinner tonight? Oh, you're going to take me to Red Lobster. You're right, I am. Why? Good guess on your part. And she'll be all excited and love you to death. But if you ask a woman where they want to go eat, oh, anywhere, pick a place, it'll never be the place she wants to go. They have to be tricked. Still the neck. This is a mild razor. So we're going to give the neck some stretchy. Yeah, stretch it. There we go. Excellent, 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 excellent. I can recommend the black tip with a more aggressive blade, like the Kai blade. Excellent, excellent shave. Excellent. Love it. Smooth as a baby's buttocks. Unless, of course, it's like a baby gator or something, but then it's not so smooth. But anyways. Yep, the lather finally got warm. I need to put it on the warmer. I'll turn it off now. I need to put it on the warmer sooner. And that's how much soap we have left. We'll give ourselves a nice face wash. Thank you. Oh, that feels good. Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh, that feels good. There needs to be a book, Breaking Woman Code. It would probably be as thick as the U.S. tax code, which is like very, very good, very good, very good. My broken piece of my Gentleman John panel block. That's what happens when you drop them. They turn to crumbs. Okay. I'm getting about a 2 on the neck. Because that is an aggressive blade. I'm getting about a half a point on the cheeks. Got myself right there. Kind of knew it by the Allen block. The Allen block let me know that I had a spot. That's okay. And that is definitely because the blade is more aggressive. But having a problem with this, is it thinner here or is it just the coloring? It looks thicker here than it does here to me. I do that, it's not bad, but then I do it on both sides of it. This side's growing thicker than this side. What can you do? Just old Walgreens witch hazel. Shake it up, baby. Wet the face, silent night. No history today, guys. I was too busy doing other things to look it up and print it out and everything. Oh, yeah. And then I'm going to use the Nivea Men Cream, what I couldn't get open the other day. Got it open today. Whoa, that's a lot. You know what we're going to do? We're going to put half of that back in the container. That's enough to cover my whole fat face, that little bit. And plus have a little extra for the arms. Also, this picture frame I had to change out today. I had a couple extra ones, thank goodness. Because the little one, the 4-year-old, was playing with that picture and dropped it on the floor and broke the frame. She didn't break the glass, she broke the frame on the corner. She dropped it right on the corner on the floor and cracked it. So the frame was, instead of being like that, was like this. You can only laugh, guys. I mean, it's seriously, she is such, she really is. I mean, she is all of that. by a color Satan spawn. My daughter doesn't like it. I said, yes, because she's just like you. Trying to clean this container of the cream up. So I put the lid back on. It had this little cover in there, but it got all crushed and down into it. I don't know what happened to it. I don't remember dropping it, but it was all down inside the cream. So get rid of that. All right, Christmas. I'll probably do it tonight. I'll probably take my Christmas shower. Because I don't shower on Saturday. I shower on Sunday. I'm retired. I don't do anything. I don't get that stenchy. So I probably shower tomorrow and or tonight, excuse me, for Sunday, and shave my head so I'm all ready to go. So, and I'll probably post the video tomorrow. All right, guys, I appreciate you being here because I got a family coming over and I gotta cook. Oh, I got spots all over my neck from that blade. Wow. Okay. We will take care of all that off camera. I appreciate y'all being here. Don't forget the affiliate link. When you use that link, I get a kickback. And when that amount in that account hits $25, I buy a gift card to the Razor Company for you guys. And I give it back to you. Don't forget the four channels I put in the description box. Subscribe to them. It's help boost their numbers. And I appreciate you all being here and joining me for this shave for Christmas. I hope everybody has a wonderful Christmas. I will see you for the head shave. And I thank you for being here. Go enjoy your Christmas. Go enjoy your family. Have some fun. Eat some food. And I will see you for the head shave later. Take care, guys. Enough of the babbling fat guy in the camera. You're in the chair next. Happy shaves out there. And Merry Christmas.